Hi, my name is Beth, and I'm the sewing pattern designer and blogger at Sew DIY. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to sew a Hong Kong finish. A Hong Kong finish is a really nice way to finish your seams if you're using medium or heavyweight fabric. I used it in this garment here. This is my Tassie jacket. I just released this pattern a couple weeks ago. And here you can see on the inside, there is this finish with bias tape. And it's very similar to a bias bound seam finish, except that on the reverse side, you don't tuck in the raw edge of the bias tape. So it creates a much flatter finish, and it's really nice when you're using a heavy fabric. It's a really great opportunity to use a beautiful bias tape and create a really nice finish on the inside of your garment. All you need to do this finish is a machine that sews a straight stitch, thread, and some bias tape. You can use pre-made bias tape or cut your own. All you do to cut bias tape is cut your fabric at a 45 degree angle to the grain line. I actually have not done a video about this or a tutorial, but there are a ton of tutorials online about how to make bias tape, so just Google it up and you will find instructions. I am using 1 inch wide bias tape. Generally, you want to use 1 inch bias tape, but if your fabric is particularly thick, or if you have a very large seam allowance, like a 3/4 inch or 1 inch seam allowance, you might want to experiment with using a wider bias tape. And you can test it out by getting some scraps of fabric and just doing a practice seam and practice seam finish. This is really a very easy seam finish to do. It's just a little bit time consuming, but when you get really beautiful results like this, it's definitely worth the extra time. So here I'm sewing a shoulder seam and I'm using a 1/2 inch seam allowance, and I have a bunch of bias tape that I've cut out, and this is 1 inch wide. So I've already sewn the seam and pressed it open. I have my machine set up on a straight stitch and my 1/4 inch foot is here. So I'll be able to just run my fabric right along here and sew a 1/4 inch seam. If you don't have one of these special feet, that's totally okay. Just figure out the accurate position of a 1/4 inch seam with your regular presser foot. So what we want to do is open up the fabric. So we're just going to be stitching on the seam and not through the body of the garment. Then I'm going to take my bias strip and put it right sides together or right face down onto my little shoulder seam. And you can pin this if you feel more comfortable doing that. I'm okay, just going no pins this time. So I'm gonna do a little back stitch just to secure it. And then just be careful that you don't stitch anywhere except for on your seam allowance. And I'm gonna keep the edge of my bias tape lined up with the edge of the seam allowance and just stitch all the way down. Okay, now let's take this to the pressing station. So first, we can go ahead and trim off this excess bias tape. Let's go like that. And then we want to press the bias tape over and cover the raw edge. So we'll just take our iron, cover that raw edge. And then we want to tuck it around the back. And you kind of want to get it as tight as possible, you know, but don't stretch it or kind of fold over your seam allowance fabric. Just wrap it around nice and tight. And ideally, you want to have the back side of this bias tape covering this seam, because when we stitch from the right side, we're going to stitch just right next to that seam allowance. So you want to make sure that this is going to cover that seam that we just stitched. So just press it down. And if you want, you can also use pins to hold this in place. I mean, you could even do a little glue basting to hold it in place. Just really tuck it in there and press, and you're good to go. Let's go back to the machine. I've switched back to a regular presser foot, and I'm again using a straight stitch. So I put my pins in parallel to the seam line so that more of the pin can hold more of the bias tape in place. So I'm going to stitch just right next to that first seam line. So it's going to be almost invisible. It's what's called a stitch in the ditch. So I'm going to be stitching right in the ditch between the seam allowance fabric and the bias tape fabric. We want to do a little back stitch. And as you go, just remove the pins. I definitely had a little wobbly there on my stitching. If you have speed control on your machine like I do, it might be wise to turn it down so you don't accidentally go full throttle. I think stitching in the ditch can be a little bit tricky sometimes. Remember, this is on the inside anyway, so I definitely didn't stitch this perfectly, but that's okay. So here we go. You can see it's mostly right in the ditch. The seam is hardly even visible, and if we turn it over, you can see that we cut the bias tape all the way down. So that's what we really want. We want to be holding the bias tape to the back of the seam allowance. And because bias tape is cut on the bias, hence its name, this is not going to unravel. So you shouldn't get any fraying back there, and it should just lay really nice and flat and be really pretty and have a nice little accent there.
Well, I hope that you found that tutorial helpful. As you can see, this is a pretty easy seam finish to do. It's just a little bit time consuming. But when you get such beautiful results that you want to show them off to everybody and wear your garment inside out, it's really worth taking the extra time to sew the Hong Kong finish. I'm going to have a blog post specifically about doing the Hong Kong finish on my Tossie robe and jacket pattern. And by the way, if you're not familiar with the pattern, I'll put in a little link so that you can check it out. The underarm for that pattern is just a straight seam, so it can get a little bit bulky, and I've devised a way of doing the Hong Kong finish for that pattern that reduces the bulk. So definitely check out the sew along linked below and check out the pattern. And if you haven't already, I would be so honored if you hit the little subscribe button down below and then hit the bell to be notified every time I release a new video. Happy sewing!